Hey everybody, this is John Stauffer, and I'm here to bring you a tech tip from Streamingteacher.com. Today I want to talk about how to manually align tabs when you're using tabs for mill or router. So this might come up especially on router if you're working on parts that wouldn't be held down by vacuum very well on their own, and so you might want to tab them together so that you can get more mass behind your part, and that gives you better rigidity so stuff doesn't go moving around. So how do we do this? I have my contour here, and this is set around these four parts. And this contour, if we look in here, it's coming real close to each other, so there's not much material left in between to hold the parts together. So we're being very efficient with the material, but we need to make sure that these parts are tabbed together so that we can keep them from moving around. So to do that, we're going to use something called square point. So if we go into the parameters and under tabs, we can see that there is an option for manual, and there's also a checkbox for use square point for tab position. So that allows us to manually dictate where these tabs need to go, and we can do it based on geometry that we put on the part. So how do you add in the points? First, go to the Home tab and make sure that your point style is set to square. So you hit the drop down and choose square from the list. Then we go to wireframe, and I'm just going to start with point position, and I will select the midpoint of these short segments here. So M on my keyboard for midpoint for each of those, and I'll do it at the top as well. Now I need to set up tabs on the other side that align with it, and we can do that with point dynamic, which is found in the dropdown under point position. And I'm going to select this edge here, and then by bringing my cursor over to the existing point, I'm actually aligning it just like that. So now I'll do the other end of it by aligning here. Then I'll hit the blue check. So that allows me to grab a different one. So I'll grab on this one now, align that to that point and that point. Blue check again, and one more time here on this one and this one. Green check here. Now this didn't dirty the toolpath immediately. I need to go into the parameters and I'll swap between these two settings. Hit the green check and regenerate. And now if I take a look at the contour, we'll see that there's actually a retract position here now. So if I were to move this a little bit off axis, you can see how that looks. And you can shorten these, of course. This is just kind of an example. But that's how we get our tabs to align with each other in Mastercam. So I hope that was helpful for you. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. But more importantly, if you are looking for high quality Mastercam training content, head on over to streamingteacher.com.